want to some wang?
Fucking wee! Welcome back to Let's Play Shadow Warrior. My wang stands ready. This is Eexecute. Welcome to the Dark Woods of the Serpent. This level is rather long, so this is probably going to be a very long episode. This level also marks the end of the shareware title. There's also a boss at the end of this level. For us, though, the trouble's only just starting. The game will cough up an Uzi right at the start. In fact, it coughs up two. There's a second one in here. Hold up a sec, though. Alright, here it is here.
Be proud, Mr. Wu.
I feel like I'm forgetting something. I am forgetting something. I forgot the fucking riot gun. Grats to me. Here it is.
I love the shuriken.
Fucking gets me every time. And yeah, okay, strong bad. Okay, so here's the deal. This is our destination. This will lead us outside, but we're going to need a bronze key to be able to navigate this door. So, we have to do a bit of fucking around in this building to get the bronze key. Our tinkering will begin on the second floor, which we can access by climbing up the ladder, but let's get some fucking shot shells first. Now, remember that little alcove we were just in? Because you're gonna have to come up here and hit a switch and then go back down there to fuck with some more fucking switches.
Isn't that for kung fu fighting you chicken shit?
Take that. Don't worry so much if you lose a bunch of health up here, because there's health kits scattered everywhere in this building. I got 7 health and I'm not worried. Besides, there was even a training dummy downstairs, and if you want to get all your health back, just go beat the shit out of it with your fists. If it's not destroyed, you can do it. You can just get your health back that way. Now, here's the bronze key, but we can't actually get through there. This button you'd think would open that little passage, but it doesn't. What that will do is it'll fucking alter something downstairs. So, that being the case, we'll gun down these fuckwits first. This should be... I thought there was 3. Must be imagining things. Let's also grab the missile launcher from up here.
Buzzay!
Be a fucking shame to miss that. I already got the gas grenade. Alright. Well, I meant to jump to the ladder, but I fucked up. Oh, well, no big deal. Now, it's the same fucking combination lock you see in the Duke Nukem games. Just hit the 2 side ones. Now head back up the ladder. What that has done is it has added a switch here. If you hit this one, this opens and you can collect the bronze key. Yoink! Now that we have the bronze key, we can get the hell out of this building. I don't understand how that fucking warrants fall damage, but whatever. I could've just beat the training dummy up, but nah, who gives a shit. Alright, let's get the fuck out of this building. Open sesame. I have a fucking wonderful feeling about this stage already. Now, be careful as you jump off this platform, because there's an exploding fuckhead here. Alright, spawn or don't spawn, we haven't got all day. No spawn, okay. We want to head out the gate, but first let's go this way. To spawn or not to spawn, that is the question. Okay, spawn it is. Fuck off, I don't like those ghosts. Alright, so this lock gate here will lead to the peasant village. It's written on the fucking side, in case you don't believe me. We're gonna need a gold key to get there though. Gold key we can find out this way in the dark woods. What's up, rabbit? There will be a rabbit in this stage who's hostile, by the way, so just loud. Oh yeah, and this place is gonna be filled to fuck with rippers.
There can be only one.
On the earlier skills, there's only a couple. On the hard ones, there's fucking tons of these motherfuckers. Fuck, I hate the hornets! They are the most annoying shitbags in this game. Well, I didn't actually mean to kill the rabbit, but okay. No heart? I don't even know if they can drop a heart if you slash them. Best way to get a ripper heart seems to be to just blow them up. Speaking of fucking hearts, that's mine, sir. I believe you got my property. Give it back. Thank you. I would suggest you err on the side of caution when dealing with rippers in here, because they can climb the trees. They're very agile fuckers. Also, if you're gonna try to fight the melee, use your sword. Try to use your fist and you'll just get murdered. Speaking of the trees, there are a couple of items you can get from the trees. They're like ammo. In fact, one of the trees even has missiles, and Holy shit, I almost fucking fired and got killed by the hornet. Fucking soda! Gotcha, bitch. God, I hate... Fuck, there's another one. Wax on, wax off. Would you fucking fire to my fists, please? Han Kwai. Go Kwai. Friggin' hornets, they're like lost souls, except they managed to be even more annoying. You see? I have the missile launcher out, they instantly fucking fly to my face, just to blow me the fuck up. You know what though, hornets aside, I am pleased. Because that. You know what they say? Two wanks are better than one.
Holy shit.
I have not managed to encounter a railgun just yet. Reason for that is because this is still the shareware episodes of the game and the railgun wasn't available then.
Holy shit.
But I want you to take note of how fast my clone is firing them. Firing those rail shots. You can't fire them that fast. In other words, he's a cheater. Do not enter. Fuck your taboos. I'm gonna enter because the fucking gold key's right there. Fuck you and your ass. Because they're fucking serious about their no trespassing laws, aren't they? I think I'll just sit back and let my other Wang do all the work. You're doing great, mate, but I still hear grunting. You've missed one. There it is. The fucking nerve of that guy. Slowly walking sideways to avoid my missiles. Alright, let's grab all the fucking Ripper Hearts, because they're awesome. And the sticky bombs. Fuck you, Hornet. Come here, fly to my fists. You know, I was tempted to see if I could actually throw a sticky bomb at him and get it to hit. Now, concerning do not enter building, you've got two ways you can go about this. As you know, I entered and got shot to shit. Well, you can crawl your way in and you go under the shots. Much like a ninja. And you can jump up for the key when you're feeling comfortable. And there you go. There's also a health kit in here if you want to grab it, and you probably do because it's the first one in the stage. Alright, there is another way you can... Who the fuck put those there? Alright, there is another way you can do this, though. This wall can be broken. And if you come up here, this is actually a secret with a nuke in it. So if you wanted to get all the fucking secrets or just a nuke, then you're gonna come up here anyway.
I like nuclear weapons.
Yeah, me too. Now there's a switch up here. If you hit this, this fire will stop. And after the fire stops, if you go back into the... Oh my fucking god, I have the worst short-term memory ever. As I was saying... If you hit this, the fire stops, and you can just run your way into the building, the shots will not fire, so you're free to just toss your wang around willy-nilly as much as you like in here. But, we have more pressing matters to do. We have the gold key, so we're gonna head towards the peasant village. What's up, rabbit? Sticky bomb time.
Better watch out.
I don't know if he's talking to me or if he's talking to the enemies with that.
Look, you have a new friend! It's all in the reflexes.
I think my personal favorite is when he says, ooh, sticky bomb Raikou. Oh man, these guys are out in force today, aren't they? Well, one of the good things about Ripper Hearts is that the Wang you generate will not be targeted by these cockheads.
Two weapons are better than one.
Observe.
You have no honor.
You know, my favorite weapon in this game used to be the sticky bomb, but now I think it's the Ripper Heart. Hey, you, come here, let's touch Wangs. Yeah. I don't give a fuck if you people think that's kinda gay. It's only gay if the balls touch. Plus, I got nothing against homosexuals either.
It is good day to die.
Oh, cheers, mate. Pop that ghost before he fucking left. Alright. Now, this next section is a bit of a maze. The peasant village is a big mishmash of buildings and trees. And I see fuckheads over here.
Kung Fu fighting you chicken shit!
I wasn't aware of any Kung Fu style that used missiles, but alright. Maybe somebody should invent one. Take the Ripper Heart. Another thing, this peasant village is polluted to shit with ghosts. Both the corporeal and the... Wait, corporeal ghosts? There's no such thing as a corporeal ghost, because if it was a corporeal ghost, it wouldn't be a fucking ghost, would it? Let's try this again with a bit more logic. It has the invisible going ghosts and the non-invisible going ghosts. That makes more fucking sense than corporeal ghosts. Come out.
There can be only one.
There's also a secret in here. You can jump through this painting for an ancient Chinese cigarette.
Ancient Chinese cigarette?
Hey, I'd smoke it. Alright, inside this little secret area you can find a suit of Kevlar plus 100. Awesome shit. Now, there's a couple more pickups you can get from around this big open building. Starting with a bunch of ammo and some health from back here. There's also missiles this way. There's also a grenade launcher to be had somewhere in this village. I'll see if I can track the bitch down. Trying not to lose my fucking bearings. This place is a little confusing. Even the map for this place is confusing as shit to look at. Alright, remember this well. That well will be important in a little bit. For starters though, let's get rid of these fuckheads. One of the great things about blowing a coolie up is that they won't spawn the ghosts because they got the corpse to do it from. Would you hold still? Alright, there's also a bit more ammo this way for the Uzi. We don't actually need any. I do love when these cunts all fly into my sword. That's very helpful. There's the grenade launcher. Alright, this door. You cannot open it. If you try, it will say requires red key. It actually unlocks from the other side. Red key is a key color we have not yet encountered. In fact, this door here needs it as well. Ugh. Come out, dickhead. Stop going invisible. There you are. Seems like those invisible going ghosts also take a few more shots. Extra health kit in here that we don't need because we haven't actually used ours yet. Let's remember that it's here though, because we're probably going to need it later. Alright, it's time for us to jump into the well, so fucking bonsai. Yep, mind the fish. Just swim through the well, you'll come out inside that building. The red key is somewhere in this room. In fact, it's on top of that big fucking painting up there. Unfortunately, we cannot jump that high. If you try, you simply cannot reach it. What you actually need to do is, well, you can grab the night vision goggles, but you see this little bucket of water thing here? If you hit the switch, it will both lower the painting a little bit, and it will also move the bucket across the ground somehow. Some very strange technology. But you can simply jump on the bucket and then jump up, and you can get the red key that way. So let's do so. Now that we have the red key, we can enter the next section of this level. We're not even halfway done with this level. This is how long this fucking level is. But, no complaining, let's press on. Through the red key door to enter the metropolis-looking area of this place. Now, the ninja are back, and they brought their stronger brethren with them, including the red ones and the stealth ones. So be prepared. Choke on this, shithead. I didn't get a very good aim on that gas bomb. I'll just have to fucking... I don't know if you guys saw that, but he hit me with a rocket, launched me back in my own gas, choked me to death, and then killed himself. Genius. Might just throw this gas bomb into a place where I'm not going to choke myself with it. That should do. They're being very frugal with their rockets. That's fine. Them being frugal with their rockets is very conducive to me staying alive. I'ma beat you down with my wang. That is some seriously fucking sick range on that gas. Alright, let's move right along. But do stay vigilant, there's more shit around this corner. Heads up, because the stealth ninjas are about to make their appearance as well. Choke on that. No fear from this gun, he just marches right through it.
Scumbag.
We all know how much that fucking shit hurts. Alright, as long as the gas is going, let's check out some... In fact, no, let's fucking run back and get the replacement medikit. And the shot shells while I'm at it. Now, as I was going to say, let's check out this building. Chinsiki's Forest Fresh Rabbit Farm. Well, inside this building, there's some Uzi ammo, but
Have fun, little rabbit.
You can fucking spawn male and female rabbits.
Have fun, little rabbit.
And they will do what rabbits are best at, which is fuck. But anyway, we're going to ignore the fucking rabbits. Let's just head through the metropolis some more. Got some coolies in the house. You know, a friend of mine mentioned to me...
pieces of shit.
Coolie is actually a derogatory term for an Asian with darker skin, like somebody from, say, the Philippines or Thailand. I don't know if that's true, but if it is... that probably makes me sound incredibly racist every time I say the word coolie, but what the fuck ever? That's what they're called. You don't believe me? Go check the fucking Pretty Realm site. They're called coolies, so I'm gonna call them coolies. Cut you up good, cocksucker. Don't worry so much if you lose a lot of health out here. There's actually several medikits scattered about the place. And by medikits, I mean the portable kind. Sit down. Say no to ghosts. Right? Let's head this way for some more fucking grenades. Come here, I wanna beat you down with my wang. You fucking sissy. You coming? Oh, fuck this. Oh, you have a body. He'll do. The more things I can beat down with my wang, the happier I will be. This let's play. The world's most elaborate cock joke. This door is locked. We cannot access it. So we'll head this way instead. Just a heads up. There is a tank out here, but unfortunately it's busted and we can't use it. Because, you know, it's fucking... It seriously does look like a tank, doesn't it? You know, it's American made.
Oh, must be American made.
Unfortunately, jumping in the tank will spawn a shit ton of shit. Luckily, they can't get to me where I'm hiding. Shh. Let me figure out how the fuck I'm gonna escape from this mess. And I think I'll just pop a fucking... Do I have a shit, I don't have any fucking smoke bombs. I'm gonna have to make a run for it. Alright, here we go. Man, that's a lot of shit. No doubt the shit's gonna fucking follow me, so we'll just wait here for it. Yep, here it comes. Another one.
Chinese New Year fireworks.
Stop spamming that broken attack. Anyway, let's actually duck in here for a fortune cookie. Fortune say, your chi attracts many chicks. Are you sure that's not my accent? Let's also grab the smoke bomb, which I could have used about 10 seconds ago. But I'm actually wanting to save the smoke bomb for a later section of the level. If you don't have a smoke bomb at a certain point in this level, on the harder skills, you're basically screwed because it's almost mandatory. Where the fuck was that flash bomb like fucking 1 minute ago?
Sprint of personality.
I would have made this section out here way fucking simpler. In fact, I actually done goofed. I should have come in here with something else first before I hopped in the tank. As long as I'm out here, though, inside this little building, you can find a replacement medikit. So let's take it. Unless I'm mistaken, there's also one more through here. This building here has a door, but it cannot open it. You have to blow it up from the back. Just like that. And it's mandatory to come into this building because there's a fucking lever that you have to press. Fuck, I should have come here first. Oh well. Let's hit this lever. That will... do something with the water inside the fucking wall, but it will also open a door. This door. Ugh, an army of fucking hornets. My least favorite enemy. There's also a red ninja in here.
How you reckon that move?
Thank you for flying into my fists. I didn't actually know this missile from here.
How you reckon that move?
Oh, you learn something new every day. Alright, where's this red ninja? There he goes. I don't give a shit if I get stung to crap. There's another fucking medikit in that room. Come here, you. And you. Damn it, I missed. Fuck this. Yeah, that's how you swap flies. You use a pair of fucking Uzis John Woo style. Alright, into the water. Some more fucking missiles, and there's that medikit that I promised you. Find the fish.
better than nothing.
Man, this bee is more than... this hornet's more than half fucking killed me. Anyway, this is what we came in here for, the repair kit. You know what we're gonna fucking repair with it, of course? We're gonna go repair that tank. A bunch of ghosts will spawn, but I don't really give two shits about the ghosts at this point. Let's head back to the fucking tank. Never mind the ghosts. Shutting up due to tank.
Call me Mr. Fix-It.
This is why I don't fucking drive. Fortunately, I don't need the cannon. Alright, tank, thanks for your service. I'm so sorry I got you fucking stuck there. Whole bunch of red ninja in this fucking hut. Would have been easier if I could just, you know, have the tank aimed at the door, but... Well, you see my fucking handiwork over there. I'm so embarrassed. Alright, let's see what pickups we can garner from here before we head through. I know there's a bunch of shit behind this house. Oop, more ninjas. Fuck them, they can wait. Let's take the gas bomb. Let's also grab the fucking... There's a fortune cookie up here. Yoink. Fortune say, a man who fight in church sit in own pew. He most certainly does. Grab the missiles. I hear them making their pain sound. What the hell's hitting them? Because it sure as shit ain't me or my tank. Sneaky.
It is natural to die.
Well, not really sneaky, more agile. Ducking under a rocket. How many of you fuck faces are in here? How do you fit so many red ninja into one building? Anybody else? Nope, that's it. Okay, cool. Oh boy, here we go. We're about to take this teleporter into Ripper Valley, and as you can see, it's full of shit. So, we're gonna make a couple of preparations. First, get your smoke bomb ready. If you don't have one, you're kinda fucked here.
I am the Shadow Warrior.
Let's do it. Fuck this! I'm bugging out. The stream down here will lead to a secret aerial. Here it is. It's quite a large, interesting looking aerial. And there's a bunch of shit on the ground in here, and there's also this rabbit. Be warned, this rabbit's dangerous. Don't fucking think he's a harmless one. I mean, I'm sure some of you have seen the corpses and bits of fucking blood everywhere, and I'm sure you can figure out what happened here. For those of you who don't know, allow me to educate you. So, this rabbit's dynamite, and even worse, we don't have a fucking holy hand grenade to take it out. That's fine, though.
Better than occupation.
I'm not here to start trouble with the legendary black beast of fucking Carbanog. Yeah, make no mistake, it will fucking attack you. What we want to do out here is throw something in the barrel. There's two fortune cookies to be gotten back there, as well as a shit ton of missiles. We'll pass the holy grail, which is broken on the way, but never mind that. I don't have time to read these fortune cookie messages, I gotta avoid this rabbit. Alright. Jokes aside, because the rabbit's not really that fucking damaging, we now have to contend with all the shit out here. Which is camping the fucking exit like a bunch of champions. Really not fucking going well. You know, I just realized something else I could have done. Never mind, that door will work with what I've... Oh, shit. I think I've just totally royally dicked myself. Oh, wait, no, I can detonate these. Shut up. If I know my subs, and I do, you will want to see the tank again. Well, who am I to deny you? As you wish.
Call me Mr. Fiction.
Wow, I died in the fucking tank. How pro as shit am I today? More tank! See if I can't lure these pricks outside, or just blow them up first. Come on, flush out. All right, quick, back in the tank.
You're not a scumbag.
It didn't really work as well as I'd hoped it would. They're all just sitting in the back of this room, jerking each other off. Damn it. Alright, got him. Now, before I get that fortune cookie, let me just quickly use my medikit and go get the fresh one.
Better than acupuncture.
Oh shit, there's a stealth guy. Fuck! Back to the tank! Alright, I'm not imagining things. I distinctively heard him fire the cannon at somebody and scream out, "How's that for kung fu fighting, you chicken shit?" What, you got fucking tank carter now? Tank fu? Sure, let's go with it. Fortune say, no man is island except Lo Wang. Shut up, Blood Reapers.
No.
I don't actually understand the reference of that no man is island shit.
3.
But let's prep the nuke.
1. All systems ready.
It is good day to die.
It most certainly is, but I'm not going to be doing that shit anymore. Alright, let's pop our smoke bomb and then head into the stream. We're going to launch a nuke to kill everything.
I am the Shadow Warrior.
Let's do it. Should be safe from it here. Alright, bombs away. The glow. The wonderful glow. Alright, let's go fucking contend with this killer rabbit once again. You know the drill, we'll just pop the barrel.
That's an ordinary rabbit.
Not gonna bother reading this, he's in a bit of a fucking hurry. Alright. Everything is dead. That means, of course, that we're safe to proceed. It also means we can grab whatever pickups around here. There's riot shells up here, missiles already collected, and a gas bomb from where you came in. Now, you might be tempted to climb up to this, cave here. Don't until you fucking clear it out. Not only is it full of rippers, it also has one of the bigger variety of ripper. That ugly shit face there. Just like a ripper, except buffed out the ass. Alright, how many's left? Quite a few. Oh, by the way, don't think you're safe down here, because the rippers will fucking jump out after you. Yoink! Well, none of them seem to have... Oh, there we go.
You're no mess with Lo Wang.
Should be safe now. Let's have a look. Well, almost. Man, look at all the fucking ripper hearts out and about. I certainly fucking approve of this. Oh wow, I've hit maximum capacity. What is max capacity? 5. Okay, 5 is as many ripper hearts as you can carry.
I like big weapons!
It's not really a big weapon. I mean, I can carry it in my fucking hand. Ancient Chinese cigarette back here.
Ancient Chinese cigarette.
It's a fortune cookie, but I don't actually need it. It's okay, I'll probably need it after... Look at all the hornets. I love it when things just have this innate way of working themselves out. I see a bunch of hornets, and the enemy blows the hornets the fuck up for me. That's awesome. Fortune say, baseball wrong. Man with four balls cannot walk. I wonder what it'd be like to have four fucking balls. Apparently I missed a ripper as well. This isn't working. Well, bullets get the job done. Speaking of which, I'm going to replenish them here. Don't forget to grab the suit of armor sitting on this rock. It's only 50, but 50 is a much bigger number than 0, so, you know. Now, this part's kind of a dick. We're going to have to just proceed down there. How do we do that? Well, we've got to ride a carpet. Before we jump on the carpet, though, let's hop over here, get the sticky bombs. Oh, my bad, the grenades, not sticky bombs. I'm not going to fucking sing A Whole New World. I know you all fucking expected me to. Let's just sit back and enjoy the ride. It's not a very quick carpet, is it?
Hey, who flying this thing anyway?
Not me, it's fucking automated. Alright, this is my stop. What the hell? Oh, for fuck's sake! You know, it's actually kind of a good thing that the game crashed. Because I missed something over here. Something important. Over here's a nuke. I don't know how the fuck I missed this last time.
Stand by.
Let's prep it, because we're going to use it.
3, 2, 1. Oh. All systems ready.
It is good day to die.
It most certainly is, but we're not going to be doing that shit. Alright, let's hop back on the carpet. We're actually going to hop off the carpet a little earlier than we did last time.
Hey, who flying this thing anyway?
Alright, from up here we're gonna launch a nuke. Over there. Bombs away.
Pain is for the weak.
See the distance that fucking damaged me from? Crazy, huh? Unfortunately though, now we just have to wait for the next carpet. Because there's a whole bunch of carpets, they just continue- Fuck you, asshole. As I was saying, there's a whole bunch of carpets, they just continue on the same loop. I think it's bullshit that I just took fall damage from landing on a fucking rug, of all things. Rugs are supposed to be soft. What is this one made out of concrete? If you smack that gong, which I did with a missile, it will drop a free medikit for you. Now, a couple of things over this way. This is just an empty cave, but look who it is.
She's ready to last doom.
What's up, Lara Croft? Let's just be taking the shit from her cell, the Kevlar, and the fortune cookie. Fortune say, man who stand on toilet, high on pot. He most certainly is. To spawn or not to spawn? Not to spawn. Awesome. There's a missile launcher back here. And there's also a extra red medikit over here. And now we have to wait... God damn it, I missed my fucking ride by like a needle dick. Alright, we're waiting for the next fucking carpet then. Does your dick hang low? Can you wave it to and fro? Can you tie it in a knot? Can you tie it in a bow? Don't need the medikit. Okay, here comes the next fucking rug. Let's see if I can avoid fall damage this time. Yes, I did. Wow, did you hear that fucking smack on my feet? It is made of concrete! Never heard of a fucking rug that was made out of, you know, such fucking solid shit. Anyway, just take a moment to admire all the scenery. I don't know what they're supposed to be. It's like the fucking underworld, or it's just some really sinister-looking crystal cave. The rug will speed up at this point. You might think there's a secret lurking somewhere around here, but there's not. We're now going to ascend slightly upwards. Nothing to do but wait for it and enjoy the Devil May Cry type scenery. We're going to be jumping off the carpet at the top. This is our stop. You see, the carpet will then turn left and will head into the wall, and if you're still on it, then you're going to get crushed when it enters the wall. And if you jump off it just before you enter the wall, you're going to be face to face with some real serious shit. Now that the ghosts are dead, allow me to show you. Yeah, four of these motherfuckers down here. Ugh, fucking carpet just tried to kill me. Now we wait. Fuck, I just blew up my fucking wang. It's alright. I have replacement wangs. Good job, buddy. Touch wangs. Alright, let's grab another Ripper Heart. There are also some fucking grenades over here. And now for what I honestly think is the shitty part of the level. This fucking big chasm with the pillars in it. Our ultimate goal is going to be over there where I was just looking. We're going to have to manipulate two different pillars in order to make passage. You can control them using this. They will rise. One of them is blue, one of them is yellow. We'll start with the blue one. This one you're only going to have to move a single time. Just put it in such a way so you can jump from that fucking ledge over on the left to it and then to the big center pillar. The one on the yellow you'll have to manipulate a couple of times, especially if you want the secret. Move it over this way if you want the secret, because you're going to have to make a drop. Alright, that should be fine. Here's hoping I didn't fuck this up. Jump from this ledge to the blue pillar and then to the big center pillar. And now jump to the yellow pillar, and if you've done this right, you should be able to just drop down into this secret area. It's worth your time, because there's a nuclear frickin' bomb down here. This will teleport you back up to the top, kind of unceremoniously. Ignore the blue pillar, just fuck with the yellow pillar again. This time, you want to take it this way, and then this way. That should be okay. Alright, let's move. Just a hit. And a scope. And now just bear with me, because this place requires a little bit of explaining. That's our ultimate goal up there. We're going to have to use that thing to get to it, but as you can see, it's way too fucking low. What you have to do is come over this way. You'll find a fucking just random throne sitting here. I don't know why the fuck it's here. Hit the switch. And you will be able to enter a tunnel that's behind the throne, because it'll just, like, shift around in a circle. Yes, this can squish you, so don't fuck this up. Through here, you'll find a missile launcher.
Cowabunga.
And more importantly, this lever. This lever will start raising and lowering that line-shaped platform outside. Because it raises to a high enough point, we can use it to get into that last section. So that's what we need to do. Now, the shit news is that we're going to have to move the yellow platform again. The reason? Well, let me show you the fucking reason. Let me just hip and scop my way back to the big pillar. The reason is that we cannot make the jump from here to that. It's way too fucking far. We need the yellow fucking pillar to do that. Elliot! Elliot! That last fucking jump is a killer. I fucked up on that so many times before. Alright, so let's move the yellow pillar over this way. About halfway between them should be fine. That should do it. Alright, let's go try our luck. Just a hit. And a scop. And that might be too far. Whew, barely. Alright, let's go. It's very hard to avoid fall damage doing that, but just deal with it.
Stand by. 3, 2, 1. All systems ready.
If you have a nuke, I suggest you prep it, because there is a boss coming up. Also, this asshat. Eh, I'll just fucking introduce him to my fucking other wang. Let's touch wangs. It's true what they say, two wangs are better than one. Fortune cookies say a whole bunch of numbers, lottery numbers. Okay, so the boss is down here. It's not a very difficult boss, just stay away from it, because it's got things that will explode if you go too close. It's got a very slow projectile that's easy to dodge. Now, hold up a sec, I need to alter the camera so you can see the health. Alright, that's done. Now, this boss will actually flee from you when you half kill it. So if we're ready, let's do it!
Oh, like I scared a little snake! you nowhere.
Hey! Come back here and finish fight!
Ogre skelly, snake, shitface!
Alright, the retreat of the Serpent God marks the end of both the shareware version and the first episode, which is Enter the Wang. The first episode, as you've seen, is very short. It's only 4 levels. The next one, Code of Honor, is much longer. It's 16 levels plus the fucking circuit levels. We're gonna get started on that next time, but for now, this has been Eexecute. Thank you for watching. Take care. Stay safe. Fuck ya.